Toys and Collectible fans, this is FlyGuy for TechSushi.com, and we're reviewing yet another LEGO Avengers set. This time, 6868, the, what's it called, Hulk's Helicarrier Breakout. There you go, try saying that in a hurry. So, this is another huge asset for the Avengers. As you can see, we get a bit of a reproduction from the movie in terms of the kind of area where Loki is captured, and basically the good guys manage to try to break out and have a bit of a fight on board this shield vehicle which they're floating above in the sky at. And you can see this shuttle or ship, whatever you want to call it, is it's not really following the movie in any way, because it's not Hawkeye that was in there. But anyway, we'll suspend disbelief and move on and review the set. So there we go, not quite a minifigure, he is one gigantic ass huge figure. It's the Hulk, and we'll get you a look at him shortly. Loki we've seen several times in reviews, but we'll give you a look at him. The same for Thor, and the same for Hawkeye, but we'll let you see that. So comic adventure is included, if you can call it that. But some of the features we've got here, a great looking feature is we can basically let Loki kind of burst out of his containment. Some canisters that fly off on a flip display, bit of the Avengers logo there from the movie. Hulk was never really on top of that jet plane, I don't think, but there we go, and he's flinging Hawkeye out. What else have we got on there? So other kind of features, really, that's pretty much it. I don't think we have anything else. We've got a flip canopy for Hawkeye's jet, and of course it would have to have flip missiles at one point. It's a Lego set. So there we go, that's pretty much the set. Let's get a look at it. So just before we do, inside the pack is one rather large manual, just giving you a brief look at the set yet once more. And pretty thick and meaty, and a good fun build it is. It's a great fun, some really interesting parts. This is the comic which comes included, it's called Number 3, but basically it recreates just about every single comic that you see. This is the Captain America version, which is in the smaller set, and it is reproduced and shrunken down, and it has all the comics basically, including this one here which we've got. So yes, all in pretty much standard stuff, but good fun nonetheless. Nice to see this kind of comic aspect coming in. And a brief look on the back of this to some of the superheroes that are coming, Spidey and a few others on there, but that's pretty much them. We've reviewed the majority of these on our channel, and check them out. Okay, we've done that. Let's have a look at this jet fighter, which it comes with. So a couple of stickers to be applied there. You can see the shield logo very clearly, and one on the top of the jet there, this kind of arrow piece forcing down, and we get shield logos that are required to be added too. So not too many stickers in this set, but quite a nice looking jet plane. Very simple build, very quick. I've stuffed Hawkeye in there with these bow and arrow, but he does fit in there pretty well. So a nice piece. Of course it comes with flip missiles underneath, but a very simple piece to put together and good fun. So let me have a look. We'll have a look at the minifigure. Nothing really much to report in the cockpit. There's just a small gear stick, and that's all you get. Hawkeye is the same Hawkeye we've seen in all the versions that we've reviewed before. Excellent kind of transfer paint application on the body itself. Really cool looking piece. He's got a reversible head, so you can see the sunglasses version on one side, and we've shown this before, but there's the version on the other side, his rather I'm not too happy face. And love that piece in the back where you've got the bows and arrows actually printed on to him, which is very, very cool. Love that piece there, and look forward to reviewing this guy in 12 inches from Sideshow Collectibles and Hot Toys very, very soon, hopefully. So there we go, that's Hawkeye. He's got his epic little bow that he comes with. We've seen that in another couple of sets, but a great bow it is. There we go. So that's out of the way. What I've done is I've taken the set itself, and I'll show you with minifigures, and then we'll get into detail. I've just put this on a base. The base doesn't come with it, but it just lets you see a little bit better. I can hold it a little better because as you can pretty much see from this, if I tilt it slightly, you'll see there's nothing basically holding this together apart from a couple of joints in each place. So it's a little bit fragile to hold up and review, but I thought I'd show it this way anyway. So it does allow you to move these pieces back and forth, So for example, these modular pieces here, in each section that you've got this, the middle, and this one over here, can move slightly back and forth on a kind of 45 degree angle. But there's Hulk, we'll show you a little bit more of him in a minute, and Loki in his chamber, and Thor watching over. So a great little set. I'll just give you a quick 360 in our usual high def and widescreen. There we go. And that's pretty much that. Now, let's get on and have a look at these minifigures. First of all, we've reviewed them before and we've given you a look, but let's look at it again. Thor with his mighty hammer. Exactly the same as we've seen in the other Thors. He's got his not-so-happy face, and if we turn that around, on the other side is his I'm-really-not-happy face, or he's going to the dentist face, maybe. Underneath the cape, we do have some basic printing, which we've seen again before, exactly the same, no difference. Still doesn't come with these flesh-painted arms, which would be nice to see a variation in one of the sets, since he does have it in this exact set here in the movie. And in the front of the minifigure, there we go, we get these standard kind of the silver buttons that he's got. And one fairly unremarkable hammer, really, pretty much. An incredibly blonde hair, he's like ultra peroxide blonde hair. Just be nice if they could have toned it down a little bit. There we go, an ultra blonde Thor that we've seen before. Another minifigure we've seen before, well in fact we've not seen this, we'll show you this one first, is Hulk Smash. Absolutely awesome. Very much like the Star Wars Wampa Cave set, this guy is just humongous. Really, he's not a minifigure, but he is to scale with the others, so he really has to be, I guess. He doesn't come with anything other than what he is, and that is one gigantic Hulk. So he's all one piece, head doesn't move, arms do swivel, and they do come off. Obviously, there you go, one blue widget piece which goes into the arm. But the cool thing is on this one, it allows you to rotate the wrists, and you can actually stand a minifigure inside there. So if I take, let's take Hawkeye, and we'll put him, if we can, squeeze him inside. Of course, when I'm doing this live, it doesn't really work, but there we go, there we go. So one Hawkeye embedded in Hulk's hand, so it does fit in there. And you can do that in both figures, so, in both hands, I should say. So, well proportioned, well done, and it really kind of fits if you look at the two together. There we go, one Hulk and one Hawkeye. So really good scale, but love it. Just massive, awesome, amazing looking minifigure. This guy is going to pale in insignificance once we get to review very, very soon the Cave Troll from the Lord of the Rings at LEGO sets, which we'll give a review to, so stay tuned for them. And if you haven't, up above the Hulk, Hulk says smash that subscribe button, because then we can send you lots and lots of reviews and you can find out what we're reviewing. So hit the subscribe and you'll get fresh reviews straight into your inbox, which you can watch there and see if you come into the channel itself. So it's a good old time saver. But that's Hulk, and he's just brilliant. Absolutely love that maxi figure. And of course his feet allow him to plug in as well, straight onto the base as well. So we'll have a look at Loki in just 1 second. But just before we do, we'll show you the play feature that works for him. On the back of the set is a kind of elastic band which builds into a piece which is up on the top, this red button. Now if I press this red button, it may drop out onto this plate, so bear with me if there's any noise. There we go, and out he goes. So he can blast out of his cell, and we get Loki. Now let's have a look at Loki himself. Exactly the same as we've seen in the other releases. Let me zoom on in, just give you that usual high def. These kind of bandolier that he's got, he's gold, and he's green on his cape, and a little bit of green on the middle of him. Nothing else, he doesn't have a reversible head, and there's nothing really printed on the back of his cape. In fact, there's nothing at all underneath, just a grey base plate. So that's Loki, got a nice squidgy kind of helmet, which works really well. And let me put this piece back in just to show you how this all fits together. So this just goes back in here, let me just put that in, but hopefully it will stay in. It's always the same when you do these things live. Oh, it's not going to stay in, is it? Let's get it upside down. What an ass. There we go. And it plugs back in. And as you can see here on the base, it moves and rotates back and forth. So there is a bit of movement, but I was trying to pin this onto this beast here to make it a little bit more stable as I review it, but it's falling apart as we speak. Here we go. So a cool thing about this set, and I'll just zoom in a little better, there we go, we get Loki's staff, which plugs into this almost like a seat. Great little stickers. You can just see there some of the sticker pieces for Loki's kind of spear is on that laptop piece there. And great clear displays, those blue displays with stickers on them for kind of control panels. Love this control panel up at the top. If you can just notice, if you remember in the Avengers movie where Thor says, in fact Iron Man says, that guy's playing Galaga over there. Well, in fact, there's a little Space Invaders on that console, if you can just see it. Really nice touch for that retro video game. And fantastic to LEGO for basically even thinking about doing that. So, not quite Galaga, but it's Space Invaders. So really well done on those stickers. Really nice touch. Nice shield logos. And really, that's all the kind of play features you get. You do get this piece here, which is down this part here, which when you tip up, allows these canisters to go flying, but it's not that exciting. But as a diorama for the guys to get together for the Avengers on the heli carrier that they have, it's pretty darn cool. So that is the set, pretty much. Nothing else really to report about it, but it's a very cool piece. Great build, great to put together. And I managed to pick this up from shopforme.com.au, which is fantastic for Australians because we get shafted by LEGO. Majorly shafted, and literally double the price in some cases than the USA, so just shocking. So thank God for Shop For Me, I'll tell you. Shopforme.com.au allowed me to basically buy all of the LEGO sets all in one, and I got a discount for buying them all together. So way cheaper prices, and just fantastic. Thank you very much, Bill and Jim. I'm so glad you guys are around to help keep me in my toy habit. If you're in the USA and Canada, you can also buy at a really good price from chowdentoys.com. That's chowdentoys.com, and they're the world's second largest LEGO store. So head along, and we've also had a few freebies that you can get into your cart. Just showing you the comic here. And you can get some little freebies when you're shopping. So when you're buying a LEGO, it's pretty simple to do. Head to chowdentoys.com. And follow FlyGuy.net or TechSushi.com and you'll get some little extra freebies. And that's it. Let us know what you think. LEGO reviews, good, bad. Do you want to see the Lord of the Rings? What sets do you really want to see us review? We need votes. We need likes. We need subscribers. Let us know and join us on Facebook.com/TechSushi. TechSushi.com. Well, not .com on Facebook. Just Facebook.com/TechSushi. But we're on TechSushi.com. Anyway. I'll shut up now. Stay tuned for more reviews, and we've got lots more reviews coming from our good friend Darth Conlon and also from our man in Manila, the wonderful FX Franz. So lots more reviews to come, and we'll see you soon. Cheers.